Champagne Party.
Hey, 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 what's going on? Welcome to Champagne Party. It's me, Sparkle.
What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Tamron, a.k.a. the Fierce One.
And it's Sophia Elizabeth. Get it right, the plug.
Get it right, keep it tight. What's going on with you, ladies? Hey, hey.
Hey.
Man, what's going on?
This traffic is what's going on. Some bullshit, let me tell you.
I think the Hollywood Bowl has something going on because I've seen their little parking people.
I don't give a good goddamn what they got going on. They need to arrange some parking over
here.
No,
one time it took me literally an hour to get through Highland. And I guess the person who sung, this old guy who sings the anthem to The Godfather, I've never heard of him before, but he was performing. And that was the worst I've ever seen Highland.
Wow.
And actually, he brought Jamie Foxx out on stage with him because my friend was there. And I'm like, who is this guy? Some old guy who sings the theme of the grandfather or whatever, or Godfather.
Oh, he's I can't popular. Even think what that song is. I can't.
Me neither. I'm like, what's the theme? The Godfather.
Somebody know it.
Some they opera all here
they
for
were
it.
All there, girl. I was like, uh-uh.
So how you ladies been? What's been going on?
Man,
it's been a whole week. Which I've been up to. I know no good.
Man, Mercury retrograde is really working some people.
You said what?
The Mercury retrograde.
Man. We're supposed to stay in the house and shut the fuck up right now. That's what we're supposed to do.
That's what's happening. That's
when my car got broken into.
It's not happening at all.
It is not. We are not doing well. What is it? The retrograde?
Yeah, retrograde.
Yeah,
some bullshit.
Yeah, I feel like it goes in retrograde way too much. Like
all the time, right?
Every time. It's in Saturn, it's in Venus. Like, come on now. Get the fuck out of here. Like,
then here comes retrograde every time.
Every time. They're like, you can't do deals. People are tripping. You don't get enough dick. Like, damn.
Who don't? You don't?
Look. There's been a lot of stingy guys.
Hold the fuck up. That's a lie.
You getting it.
No, I'm talking about Sophia. Oh. She talking about
Sophia. I mean, I take what I can get, but you know.
This nigga right here. Oh, okay, Lord. We gonna leave that one alone. Tamron, what you been up to?
Man, we went to Vegas this weekend. It was a fun little trip.
Vegas? That's Vegas. It?
I mean, no, I went home.
Use a well. Motherfucking lie. I'm busting you out. Stop.
Marquisha, call in.
Stop.
Can you call in? Who's Marquisha?
She set it up. Marquisha, if anybody asked you if I was out there.
Yeah. Why y'all policing me anyways? I'm a grown-ass woman, dog.
I
ain't talking about that because I don't want to talk about that. Why would I? I don't want to talk about it. I went home for a family matter that I don't want to talk about, and then I went to Vegas afterwards. Is that okay? Can I take a trip to Chicago?
I don't think you were in Oklahoma for 2 hours, bitch. That's not fucking what I think about 2 hours.
I wasn't there for 2 hours, but I was there for one day.
And then this nigga, she gonna call me. It looked like she was in a barnyard. She like, this is a good spot right here.
Whatever.
Made it look like we in Oklahoma.
I was at a restaurant, bitch.
Yeah, that's on the way to Vegas.
That is not
city.
On the way. Where was that? Where was that?
Damn,
where was
what
that?
The fuck? Like, no. What kind of lie are we where talking about that? Right now?
I don't know. They've been policing me the whole time, I guess.
So he was
FaceTiming me. Am I there?
Wait a minute. You FaceTimed me.
Oh, yeah, because you were bullshitting and asked me a million
questions. I wasn't
bullshitting.
On a text message. No, because on a text message, I get, where you at? And I say it. Are you sure that's where you're at? And I'm like, what the fuck's going on?
Hold on. First, if you're going to quote me, you need to quote
me
right
now.
Let
me quote you.
Pull it up.
Let me quote you.
That's not what I said.
Hey, so where were you last week?
I don't know. In hell. I don't know.
In hell, they made it sound like you were in heaven.
I wasn't.
They made it sound like you were in heaven.
You don't have to because it's not for you to believe. But you know,
they made it sound.
I don't really care to.
Then the kicker was, we was in the living room, we had comedy night, it was cool, and that's what was going on. That sounded like heaven, the one you couldn't get away from. She showed you the video, and then she was like, wait a minute, you didn't see it on your timeline. I was like, no,
because
I wasn't on Instagram.
I was
like
talking
that.
About
it
the
was
experience.
In the story. Oh, it's gone now.
It is
it's
not
24 hours. I was like, well, ain't that
do,
some
do you
shit?
Want to see it? Is that what you want to do? You want me to just show you and prove it?
No,
like,
yeah,
is that what you?
To me,
No. Let me show it.
I
would have
believed
it
if you had took a picture next to some cows and shit, but I don't,
I don't
know.
We don't have cows in our backyard.
Y'all sound like some kids.
So, okay, so it was a funeral, y'all, and he's singing I'm So Alone at the funeral.
Damn that boof-ass Android.
At the funeral, okay? Can you see?
No, I can't see. It's on a boof-ass Android.
Goddamn
Android-ass phone.
Jeez.
Androids are like...
I can't see shit on that.
There's some good Androids.
Which one? That's not the good one.
Which one? Who would spend $200 or $300 on an Android?
You spend $1,000
on an Android? Y'all need to see my family? Okay. I don't know. Did y'all need to even see pictures of the family?
Turn your shit off. She was like, send it to me so I can see what's going on. Okay. So it feels like I'm there.
All right.
Jesus. But no, you know, I know the situation. Hopefully you wouldn't tell fib about that. You know, it's a sad situation, but you know.
You know what I was about to say? She she went to Oklahoma like people go in people's lives. They go right in and come right out. Like, motherfuckers,
that's what we had left. That's what we went for. We already had other shit to do.
They were like, this brand new ass bitch, you haven't been back in how long?
So I'm coming back, but I can't, look.
Take me with you next time.
I was with you. I was with somebody that had plans already.
Mad because she didn't go out there and get some Oklahoma dick. That's all.
I'm mad.
Shit.
No, you know what though? First 48 be on Oklahoma all time, so I don't know if I want an Oklahoma dick. Like,
y'all are crazy.
It's always in Tulsa. And shit, like
it's okay. But Spider, so we gonna get off camera real
please
quick.
Help these people.
Lord, please help these
I'm
people.
Praying. You know I'm we praying. Love you.
I'm praying right
we
now.
Gotta give you a hard time because you give us a hard time. But it's anyway, okay. Spider, how was your week?
It's been cool. I got my rent money.
Oh shit! Wait a minute. Hold up. Wait.
You feel me?
Wait a minute. Yeah.
He
How'd you
a lot
get
of thirst traps.
How'd
you?
I
know. I fucking just He's walked into one by accident. And I was like,
how's that happen?
You know how you're on the phone and Instagram and then the stories pop up and you accidentally click on some shit. And I was like, wait a minute. Did you see the message? I was like, oh shit. Why are you doing that?
Why am I doing what?
He sent you a picture?
I didn't send nobody.
No, he didn't send me a picture, but you know the story. He posted in a story, and then I was doing some shit and clicked on it, and then I was like, oh, shit.
And you know? Liked it?
What?
She double tapped.
She was like, oh, shit.
So wait, let's go back.
She slid in my DMs. She said, oh my god, I'm scarred for life. If you didn't want to see that shit, why are you telling me?
She
should have just left that shit alone. All you gotta do is keep going.
That's not what
All you gotta do is keep going.
I'm just like, what the hell? You know, you could tell who see it. I'm like, look at, she all up in my shit.
No.
You know,
I can look through my list. I can look through my list and know who was like. I can look through my list and know who was like. Oh yeah.
Look, she liked them light skinned niggas. She was stalking you.
He's like a little bro. Shut up. Anyway,
You know what though? Back to how you got your rent money.
Exactly.
I've been working. What you talking about? I've been booked.
Booked how?
Booked and busy with this camera.
Oh, so no luck in the.
Oh no, she ain't sent me nothing. It's where we at, Sparkle?
He's waiting.
Where we at, Sparkle?
We're
you know
working
what,
out the packages.
I hit up Wes B. Wes B said she has some. And I
Wait
hit her
a minute.
Up.
It gotta be white women only.
That's all I got. Okay.
So what we talking about? Where they at?
Hermosa, Redondo, Malibu.
Where they at?
I don't give a fuck where they at. Palos Verdes, San Bernardino,
No. I don't do Dino. Dirty Dino, them hoes is destiny.
They might have a little baby mansion.
No, I beg to differ because Rancho,
you didn't say it. San Bernardino, so it doesn't even matter what you're about to say.
No, not San Bernardino. I did not say San Bernardino.
I know.
No, remember where John lives?
That's bullshit.
That's the richest area code in California.
Okay, and it's out there. So
Rancho Santa Fe. It's the richest area code.
Santa Fe.
Rancho Santa Fe.
It's the biggest house I've ever seen. Bigger than any fucking celebrity out here.
Well,
and they're rich out there.
I mean, the land is cheap. The land is cheap out there.
They're looking for a young black dick like yours.
So they can pay your rent.
You feel me? A car note too, or some student loan debt?
Come on, talk about a car note. They'll buy you a car.
Right.
I need another one.
Fucking note.
In cash.
No car note.
Okay, damn.
Everybody talking big shit about all these women they got, and none of them are to be found.
So you ready? You really ready?
None of them are to be found.
He is ready to.
What do you mean? They're out and they're ready. You just have to
No.
You
listen.
Take the older, the better.
Listen.
No.
Listen. That's not what I'm talking about.
He wants us to find the hotties to give to him. There
you go.
Pay him.
There you go.
So we have to find the hot cocks that are willing to pay
for
the
hotties. Whoa.
My bad. Google has named cocks into guys, so my bad. That's my apologies. My bad.
Cocks. Okay, so cocks are women too?
No, it's me.
Oh, okay.
Sophia.
Yo.
Oh, this one?
Don't get it twisted.
We can have a cock.
That's what I heard.
But we can strap our cock on. They want the real class.
And on that note, we're going to go ahead and cut to a little champagne break. And we got some fire for you coming up. So we're going to go ahead and let DJ Westby take it to the break. And we're going to be right back.
One. Back.
Hey, hey, what's up? We're back with Champagne Party, Marks King Presents Dash Comedy, and we're gonna get some tea going.
Yes, we got a special guest coming through. We got Slim 400 coming through. He gonna tell us what's been going on, and you know, it's a lot been going on with him, but first, we gonna go ahead and Sophia gonna start us off with the tea. So what's happening?
Well, there's a lot of scandal going on the internet, people cheating and getting caught. Which, you know, I don't think I'm for cheating if you're married, like Nicole Murphy.
I'm not for cheating, period.
I mean, if you're just dating, then, you know, he wants to go, you know, whatever, then that's fine. But when you're married, it's different.
Wait, why is that fine?
Yeah, that's an open relationship.
If you cheat, I'm cheating too, and I'm going to cheat worse. I'm going to get your daddy, your grandpa. God damn.
Your daddy and your grandpa?
I will get them all. I will get down your whole gene line. I'm not going to get your mama. No, I'm
joking. I'm with the mama.
I'm not messing with DJ West.
No, but my whole thing is Nicole Murphy, she's good looking. Then they had some really fucked up pictures of her on Daily Mail. She was not looking airbrushed and, like, you know, tightened up like she normally looks. And they caught her with Layla Rashawn's husband.
Oh, yeah. And she tried to, she made
That's who she was that kissed the guy, right?
Yeah, they were kissing. And she tried to, Nicole Murphy put out a statement that said basically that they were just friends and they ran into each other. And the pictures clearly show them kissing. So there was not just running into each other.
Yeah, it was two pictures of them kissing.
Right.
I mean, they said best friends?
Well, they were in Italy, right? Or France? Or they were somewhere far, so it's like,
right.
I don't...
So that's what I'm saying. Is that a setup? Because all of a sudden, paparazzi see all this shit, and...
Paparazzi's everywhere, though.
Why? A setup to do what, though?
I don't know. Nicole Murphy been out the loop for a minute, and
but he's
a
married man. Why would she want to set herself up with him?
I don't know. Maybe the wife is too, you know?
She do anything for clout.
No, the wifey did not know.
Are you sure? You know, there's a lot of actors out
here. And he's fine, so I would...
He was the what did he do? He was the director or something.
He was the director.
Same day, right?
Yeah. So. And something else that was pretty huge. But I mean, Nicole Murphy should just go get her a couple little, you know, young tenderonis that play sports and just call it a day. Like,
yeah, I guess if they play.
Spider. She got Spider.
No, she's looking for a young millionaire. She only dates men with money.
Spider ready for everything.
Almost, not yet.
But isn't Eddie like on his like ninth kid with this white bitch though? Like, I'm sure she's going through it. Like, you know, she got Eddie's money though, so why would she?
I don't know, have anything to do with it.
Eddie is getting paid a lot of good money.
Right.
He is about to have a Netflix series that's like over 100 mil. Like, he is getting paid very good money.
Yeah, but I don't think what she's doing has anything to do with Eddie.
If she's not about Eddie, why don't you just change her name back to whatever it was? She's not married no more.
True story.
Why would you keep the clout?
Exactly.
And do anything for clout.
Do anything for clout.
Yeah.
She probably feels like she earned that name with all them damn kids that she had.
She was looking good back in the day, but she looked crazy in Daily Mail. That's why I'm like, Photoshop's a bitch.
But I seen her in person like a month ago, and she did not look that bad. Like, she was actually beautiful in person when I seen her. I recognized her.
You're from Oklahoma. You're very nice.
Very nice.
She looked like a man.
She was looking cute.
She looked like a man to me. But she is gorgeous. She's a good looking man. But...
She got the real LA in her. She know the trannies.
Wait, she's a tranny?
I didn't say that. I'm just saying she knows, like, the masculine looking female.
Yeah, no. You know what, though? Guys like that shit. Because, you know, Spencer, she has a bald head. They always grab the back of her head.
I'm not messing with you.
They like no hair. Because it doesn't get in the way when you're giving head, you know?
She always says something like that, though.
No, I swear.
No, seriously, babe. They like dark hair. Like, she's always telling me what the men like. You switch it up.
No, they want a bald head and a manly looking face. Look at fucking Tiana Taylor. Her man is fine. And this bitch be looking like a straight donkey, nigga. Like,
whoa. What the fuck? You tripping, Tiana Taylor, fine as hell.
After all that surgery, probably she is fine to you, but she looks like a man. You must like men.
You know what?
I don't understand why you don't want to go out with me. Damn, nigga, we trying to put you on.
Time out. That's super crazy. That is super crazy, yo. Y'all tripping.
I heard she looked good, but if you remember seeing her on Sweet 16, she looked really manly. And then she started progressing her look when she got surgery and her nose and all that shit. I'm not against it, but it's like, guys do like manly looking bitches. Let's just be honest.
Is that what y'all like?
No, I have no idea what the fuck we are talking about right now, because that makes no damn sense. I'm saying, I'm the only nigga on the mic. It's so bad for me right now.
Because I get a lot of men that come at me and I dress like a dude, and I get a lot of y'all fuckboys. I'm not saying you. But a lot of you fuckboys want to come at me, and I'm like, I wear the same boxers as you, nigga. What is you doing?
But then what are they coming at you saying? What?
What's the deal? What you looking like? You thick as fuck.
What?
What's the... Hey, can we... no, nigga, where's your wife at so I can fuck her?
No, they know what you got between your legs, which is why they, like, come over here. Like,
what? Wow. Look at me. Like,
they want to turn you back. That's the ultimate
How can you
goal?
Turn me
That's
back if thing. I was never that way?
Oh, well.
I tried.
You know what it is? No. They get the best of both worlds. You look like boyish. They get their gayness out of there, and they get.
But it's still a vagina.
Exactly.
Nah, not me.
That's why they're all for trannies.
It's too much. All right,
so we're about to move it along. Tamara, tell us what's up with the hood news.
I do not know what's going on with the hood this week.
God damn it, you're supposed to know what's
we finna
going
have
on
Slim
in the hood.
Up in
we,
here.
I know, right? That's what the Slim 400 is going to be.
That's
what's going on
times. He's as hood as we can get.
Do you think he's going to want to talk about that, you know?
He's yes. did interviews about
he,
that.
He, okay. He loves it. He's good.
He loves it.
He's like talking about gangster shit. You know? Yes.
He's like, we all.
I think that's very sad, though, that continues, you know, in our community. That's why that one girl, when she put a statement on saying she got her title stripped of Miss Oklahoma, I think, because she said, oh, black people just kill each other, so stop trying to blame it on the cops.
Oh, no. They say, give us that shit back.
But she ain't black. She was Asian, so it was like...
take that whoa. Shit.
Oh, she was Asian. I'm yeah, we get killed girl. By all of them, from the police to us, ourselves, yes, but
she
not
was like,
just...
that's it, give us our shit back. Yeah, you barely won back. It anyway.
You know, Oklahoma probably was okay with that shit.
But no, we gonna see. He's open to talk to... you know, about all that was going on.
Hey, hold on. You got a Starburst?
I do.
You going to share, you gonna share some Starburst?
What else? I see the gold package over there.
Yeah, that's the only way to go. Only way to go, baby.
Why is it empty?
Because she already used it before. That's why she was late.
You know what? I'm looking for it.
That's why she was late. 6 minutes late because she got that 5-minute quickie and she walked in after 6 minutes.
You know what? I'm done with y'all. I'm looking for my goddamn gummy savers. Okay, gummy bear.
Which ball player was this?
That's what I'm looking for.
Were they infused?
Yes. Yes.
It was the new one that just got signed to the Lakers. It was that guy.
Oh, that didn't make
the fuckboy haircut. It was him.
What the
fuckboy haircut? That's the one who she gave the gold rubber
the magnums. To. Okay.
What is y'all talking about?
Y'all done made up a whole scenario. I'm sitting up here trying to get my
you
face
out here
on
fucking
some candy.
Lakers.
She said gold rubber.
So I'm out here fucking Lakers. See, that's how you get shit started.
Yeah. Oh, you clapping?
What else is going on? What else is
clapping? Felicia fucking Lakers, y'all. Yeah,
I know I fucked a few, so.
Is your pussy good enough for us to get front row seats?
Obviously not.
Not.
Shit. You know what though? The thing is, I've never not any of the guys I fuck with, I've never asked.
They don't even play anymore, huh?
No, they just, of course they
right, okay.
Play. They
are you still messing playing? With like the first rings or like the second and third?
Oh,
rings?
never second or third. Okay. It's always first.
So they should be able to give us goddamn front row seats.
You know what? I never asked.
See, fuck with Kyle Kuzma.
Shit. You gave them you know what, so a box.
I can't get us in one of the skyboxes, though.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
When?
Like, When? Whenever.
We need that. All that.
But you know what? It's courtesy of Percy.
Oh.
Let's talk about that.
I'm not going to tell her.
It's courtesy of Percy.
No. Get in there and get cussed the fuck out.
No, he won't be there, though, because, he's going to hook me up with the guy who can get us down there.
Took you up with the guy, pussy. So he got oh, bird. Okay. Courtesy of pussy, we gonna get that skybox.
Yeah, okay. No, I'd rather fuck with Percy anyway.
Okay, and on that note, we're gonna go ahead and cut to a break. Right, we're about to call Percy's ass right damn now and see about these skybox seats, okay? Sophia's about to hook it up, okay? She said she can do it. So
I can do it.
We're about to make this call, and we're gonna be right back. Brought to you by Marcus King Presents Champagne nice Party on Dash Comedy.
I'm bringing a bitch with me.
Yeah, it was a little back and forth about what the hell were we talking about?
About manly looking bitches.
Manly looking bitches.
and cheaters.
And cheaters. We talk about cheaters all the time.
I know. It's always the topic.
know.
I feel like it's more though. Like now, because like you know, I mean, we ain't gonna give our age, but growing up. Mm-hmm. Guys, you know, they took their time to deal with you, and it wasn't just, you know, like you could just go on social media and look at ass all day.
Right.
So
that's all they do now.
Yeah.
Looking at ass.
Y'all look at dick all day. Shut the fuck up. Let me see your timeline. Let me exactly my point. I'm looking at ass.
Dick print.
I'm looking at ass.
I don't be going on social media to look at dick.
Bro, let me see your timeline. Let me see your timeline.
You can see it.
No, that's not looking at. Look at the last things that she liked. Look at the double taps.
Never dick.
Look at
y'all don't double tap nothing. Y'all just look at it. We just happen to double tap it and make it popular, I guess, you know?
Whatever.
It's like every Instagram influencer.
Like how a girl looked in her face, not back here. We like, can't. You could look like a donkey, like I said, and then your ass makes you look like you're Beyonce.
That double tap don't mean nothing besides booty.
I've seen a whole lot of shit. They got body and just, you know, muffins and all kind of shit going on. And then you look at the face and I'm like, what the fuck? This is what you sent up here liking all day? Right. Like, wow. Like, yeah, she got some body. You know, she's showing all her shit. But look at the face.
You know, have you seen those memes? Have you seen those memes? Stop twerking and see if you can read or some shit like that. It was like, I want to read out loud instead of twerking or something. I want to know if you're, like, dumb or not. But that's
true.
They don't
give a damn about that shit.
They don't.
They got to see
the dumber the better, actually.
The right.
They are the more
Siri is reading for him right now.
Well, that goes to show we're gonna have a lot of dumb offsprings coming out.
Crazy. Anyways, but we were needing to get on the topic of fake friends. You know, we were supposed to do that last week.
Oh, like
we got in the mix.
My fake friends. No, but she will leave. She will leave you for some dick.
No, I won't leave you for dick, but I will leave you for my man.
Ooh. Which is dick.
Dick!
It's not about dick, though. At that point, it's past that. To me, and I won't say I'll leave you, because I will go out, but I'll go home at a decent time. I'm not going to stay out after after the club. Like, I'm not going to do that.
But would you disappear?
I will go home.
No, would you not talk to your friends no more in the account of your man?
No, I will. If you talk about that, have you ever seen me do that?
No, just in general. You know, some girls, you just be like, I haven't heard from this bitch in years because she got a man. Like,
you know? Some of them like that. I like to keep it open. Like, I like my friends to be included, period. Like, and I feel like if that's your man and you... And you leave your friends for your man, like, was that really your friend? Because, I mean, because real friends are going to keep in touch regardless.
Exactly.
Yeah, but then you won't be seen for a while. I mean, not saying you, but I'm just saying some girls who do
that. Who done fucked you over, Sophia? She like, no, but you won't be seen for a while.
His number is 323, and I'm sure.
What friend did you wrong for a man?
You know what? When I first came to L.A., I had helped a lot of bitches out that were... You know.
Why they gotta be bitches? You know what?
Because they bitches now.
I'm trying to
remember
stay
that
away
night
from the word.
Remember that
bitches,
night when I was
bitches now.
Remember that night when I was telling my ex about the Aunt Jemima titty bitch?
Yes.
So yeah, it was bitches like that would, you know, kind of they would like want to show you know, I call them bait girls, that they can take your nigga or that this nigga will wanna fuck them. So you know, I love having bait girls around because it lets me know that, hey, I can't trust this bitch, and not only that, he ain't for me. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, guys, I don't like equal opportunity, guys. That's the thing. Like, if he's for you and I'm around looking cute, he wouldn't come at me.
Right. Exactly.
You know, and I don't want him either. So, but there are bitches that will try to show, like, hey, I'm going to flirt with your dude because they know, you know, and it's like, I can't deal with that.
I've had it done. I was like, really? And he came back to me and I was like, oh, you was all, like, they would come to me telling me, oh, yeah, she was out there doing the most, all up in my face. I was like, wow, really? Okay. Mental note. Mental note.
Hey, I've had a friend go all the way with it, so. Mm-mm. Yeah.
Have you went all the way with one of your friend dudes?
Never. I ain't never.
That's crazy.
Even came on to or anything. None of that.
That's crazy. Not a slide in a DM. Like, that's off limits. It's, I don't know. It's like. Females, they don't respect the girl code. They don't respect any code. They don't give a shit about nothing. They gonna do whatever they wanna do because maybe they've been hurt in the past and whatnot. So they feel like, hey, fuck it. I don't give a shit about nothing.
Yeah.
Even the homies that have held them down when they went through the bullshit. But,
you know, we gonna get off that.
Hot girl song?
I would say people in general.
Hold on, you sound like it. She sound like she's talking to someone in particular.
No, I call them big girl.
A few in particular.
You know?
A
big bitch.
Yeah.
And it's so funny because they don't know that the dude would come straight back to the women and let them know, like, hey, she was doing this and this.
Certain dudes blah, will. Blah, blah, some blah. Dudes
some
will.
Some won't.
Real nigga will.
Yeah. A real nigga will.
Right.
He will report that ass.
But, man, you can't be that thirsty where you're, like, sliding in bitches' DM talking about you look cute. Nigga, do you know we're friends? Like, all he's waiting for is for her to respond so they can end up hooking up, you know, and then you ain't gonna find out. And it's like... You know what I mean?
But
you like,
should if that's your friend.
Exactly. Right, she should say something. Yeah.
If that was a real friend, it would have been told right from jump. Like, hey, not a continue-on conversation. Like, who does that? Even if it was innocent or whatever. Like, you know, it is what it is.
No, it's working up to something for sure. That's the thing. They're working up, or she is, or he is, if you're continuously talking and, like, hey, you know, like, right. Why are you...
Right.
You might as well just give the number, like, and talk on the side. Shit, but that's why you gotta keep at least five. That's all I'm saying.
Five
pieces? So you knock one off, alright, bye, nigga, I got another one.
How many you got sitting in the cup right now?
Huh?
How many is sitting in the cup for you right now?
That's probably like 15.
And she said five!
I'm just saying, I mean, you gotta have options. I wouldn't fuck all of them. It's just, you gotta have options, you know? Like, these guys nowadays, they really feel like, you know what we were talking about earlier? Like, you want to be up under them? No, nigga, I just want some dick. Like, stop making it seem like it's you.
But when does that get old, you know? When are you willing to just have that one person, you know? That shit gets old after
that's
having, like, 15.
No, I get it. When you know, you know, though. When you know, it's like, you just don't leave them. Like, you just know. Like, when my last relationship, I just knew. You know, and that was a long time ago. But I just feel like now I don't have that connection with some people, even though I want it. But for now, I'm just enjoying single life. But when you know, you know. You know what I'm saying? And nothing can get in between that, especially if the guy has his wandering eyes. If he has wandering eyes and he doesn't realize that you're on top of the list or you're better than these bitches, then he ain't for you.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Because pussies comes a dime a dozen. And I heard a lot of these bitches got some whack-ass pussies.
Damn.
I am not paying your Metro bill for that pussy.
No, bitches be bugging, coming back broke, hungry. I'm like, bitch, you on the train?
You can't even get a Happy Meal for that shit. Like, not
no,
me.
No.
You can
bitch.
Get $1.49 bag of chips though.
Oh damn!
I done went off of plenty of bitches in those situations. Like, bitch, you cannot be my friend. Okay, like,
what they get? What
just
they come
stop
back
fucking
with
randoms. They need to get their life together. Right. To me, like, why are you even out there fucking randoms? You probably should work on yourself so you can attract what's right for you. To me, exactly. In my opinion, yeah. And that's what I'll do. I'll be by myself and just like work on me,
exactly.
Instead of trying to fuck with random ass niggas, because I got too much, you know, too much other shit to worry about.
Yeah,
fucking like no. You gotta come to the table with more than just fucking, like.
But some of them, that's exactly. All they want. They just want to fucking fuck. That's okay, they just want to be like, I fuck this nigga, that nigga, this nigga, that nigga, this nigga, that nigga.
But what about if you gonna get something out of it, get something long term, like
exactly.
Build a business,
exactly.
The fucking investments, like yeah. You fucking for like $2 and shit.
You fucking
like, that's
for Louisiana
awful.
Meals.
That's awful. If you gonna
for free.
Do it, do the shit right.
Well, hey, for shout outs on Instagram.
They fucking for free.
That's fucking literally for
on
free.
On Instagram Live.
Wow. How do you know it's free, though?
Huh?
You might be live and get paid live.
Shit, if you didn't came over for free.
No, you know what, though?
You was the one.
Those free bitches have fucked it up for the rest of us. Okay? I'm telling you. Like, and I heard these bitches that came out here doing it for free were from Miami. So all you Miami bitches. No, I swear to God.
Location.
All you Miami bitches, because I was in the strip club before it was some Cardi B shit. All you Miami bitches came out here and was selling your poom poom for $100.
Damn.
When you used to get $4,000 or $5,000 just getting your feet rubbed.
Yeah,
Sophia
mad.
Shit, I'm
some
mad.
Shit.
I got mad all the time. These Miami bitches fucked it up. Time. You know what it is? It's not just the Miami bitches and fucking South American bitches. Because them bitches, $100 is like $1,000
to their country.
Shorty said,
"Oh God,
I'll tell you next subject."
Talking about $5,000 for feet rubs.
Well, I'm right.
You must be a part
now
of
on that
note
of the feet rub, we're gonna go ahead and cut to break real quick. This is Champagne Party brought to you by Marcus King Presents, and we'll be right back.
Shorty was turning it.
Party is Sparkle in the building, ladies. What's up, y'all? This is Tamara, aka Fierce One.
Sophia Elizabeth.
Okay, look, I'm about to
in the building. You got Slim 400
in the building.
He on the
telephone.
Super busy person. How you come to an interview on the phone?
Right,
he on a big
conversation. We gotta wait for a minute.
Hold on, ladies.
Where's the location? Do that. I gotta get off the phone. Give me like 15, 20 minutes. I'll pay your line back. We can talk about it.
Oh, I bet. My bad, I apologize. Welcome. No, I was like, hold on, wait a minte, I don't want to be rude. Big plot, you know, what's going on, Slim, how you been? Man, I'm cool, man, chilling, man, I'm blessed, you know what I'm saying, thank you, but I'm cool, you've been busy since the last time we seen you, we seen you last in what, April?
Yeah, well, y'all was asking me all them deep ass questions.
No,
that's what you got.
You wasn't, no, didn't get in trouble.
No, you know, I'm a real nigga, so I was just doing that, man.
Well, how come we didn't get invited to the booty video shoot? Because I hit you
the
up.
Booty.
Yes, remember you booty. Was dropping that.
So,
table.
Look, this is what happened. Mm-hmm. My manager didn't keep in contact with y'all. Mm-hmm. That's how I'm supposed to go.
Oh, okay.
See, it'd have been wrong for me to get one of y'all numbers. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I don't want to do business like that. Yeah. So he posted, like, you know.
So we didn't, he slipped, he's slipping on the job.
That's why they didn't want to come in here. You know what happened.
So he wants to fuck shit.
That's hard.
He wants to fuck shit, don't want to realize.
I ain't saying, but yeah, kind of like that.
That's real shit. That's real shit.
It's not his fault. We just gonna sweep that up under the rug real quick. But how was it? So it's that booty, right?
That booty.
Oh, okay, that was cool. It was a lot of booty up in there, right? Oh yeah, it was some ass at that thing. No booty or just asses? Was it dumb booty or was it like ass? It was all the above. All right, now tell us about Ice Water before we get into it. Ice Water, basically, my label that I'm pushing and running with right now.
I feel it stands for just, you know, being a cold nigga in these streets, 10 toes down, and moving forward in life, and ain't going for nothing.
Okay. Period. So what is different about this genre of music that you created with Ice Water? Because it's an album. It's a whole, you got some shit popping with it.
I feel it's just me being within a solo artist and, you know, speaking my stories. You know what I'm saying? And, giving my half of the whole little, shit.
What kind of stories are you speaking of?
Shit.
Cold
family.
Real life.
Women. Real life. Homies. Enemies. You know.
All
shit,
the world. Right. Do you speak of any cheating?
Look at her.
I just want to know.
See, she the one.
She's the one.
You shot us on the day we were just going in about cheating.
I don't speak on. It's like when you flip it to the TV, you see cheaters, you try to pass it up. Like,
I got nothing to do with that.
Fuck this shit. It's that bullshit.
But nah, if I had to, I would. But for the most part, I don't talk about none of that, man. Cause
no relationship.
Niggas be on. That's what you be doing. That's what you be on. That's what's going on. Yeah. Let me know.
Right. You're giving juice away. You're giving the plots away.
Okay.
So is it safe to ask, do you have a specific someone in your life right now? You know we gotta ask that. We just wanna know, because we wanna know how deep we can go. We don't wanna offend anyone, so.
Nah, we good. I go all the way, shit, to the street with it.
Last time we was talking,
what was we talking about last time? Licking toes?
I wasn't here last time.
Romance.
Were you talking about licking toes?
Well, we was talking about something.
Yeah,
I was actually.
Hey,
but it was okay. They was talking about sucking and shit.
Right.
Sucking and fucking and shit.
Yeah.
That's
always.
Always.
Can y'all ask him if Tiana Taylor like a man?
That's a good question.
Do you think Tiana Taylor looks like a man?
Tiana Taylor?
Yes.
No, it's just when she get angry, the way I look at her, she's beautiful. That just overall, period. But when she get angry and she on her tip, she can be that nigga. You know what I'm saying?
She got that New York shit going for nothing.
You got certain females that'll not let a nigga do whatever, but
you got certain females that be like, all right, for sure, bro, whatever,
and keep it calm.
Right.
If she feel like you out of line or you doing some bull stuff, she on some shit like, you know, what up? Like,
that's what she just did last week. I mean? She was on the court. I don't even know what happened, but she was like all up in his face like she was about to fight the dude. I'm like, what the hell is going on? Well, then she was saying something about you on my team. I was like, what? They rigging games and shit?
She ain't no sucker, man.
Yeah, no, and I've watched her show before, and she's like farted and picked her nose, and I just feel like that's not woman-like.
But at the end of the day,
but that's her.
That's how she get out. You feel me? So that's how she get out. You feel me? I know women that do shit like that too. I'd be like, girl, but you can't stop certain people. You feel me? Everybody different. So would you still be attracted to someone? Would you still want to date them? Is that a turn on? For me though, that's a turn on. For me though, she walks in, it's a turn on.
Like, excuse me though.
She can say excuse me all she won't.
This nigga wants somebody that's gonna fart in the goddamn bathroom and shit.
She gotta walk somewhere else and get some milk.
Exactly.
I wouldn't do that anyway, so that's unladylike to me. So.
It is.
You
say that shit now,
you
go, ooh.
Nuh-uh. Really, I have never. You can ask anyone I dated. Like, never seen that.
She got me going.
Girl. Stank, stank.
Okay, so Slim, what kind of women do you like? We forgot last time. Said, you know, shit changes. You know, preference changes. So we got to keep up to date with you. What kind of women?
Me personally, I like, I just like a woman that this, you know, be on her own, independent, like, movement. You see what I'm saying? Like,
shit.
A job is a job. At the end of the day, if you can go for that top-notch job, or you could do something that kind of open the nigga eye to where it's like, all right, she just ain't no regular chick. You feel me?
Yeah.
She got her own money. Don't trip on, like, going half or doing this today because I might got it tomorrow, or she go out to dinner, she paying for this, then I pay for this. It's like 50-50, you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All that, I gotta do it. Like, man, look, check this out, I'm single. You see what I'm saying? You ain't about to keep working me.
Would you ever buy a woman roses?
Oh, I do it. Yeah.
Oh, I do it. I do it.
Wait, do you get the roses off the side of the freeway?
It depends on what type of day that is. if I got some shit to do, but I was thinking about you, it's considered the thought.
Right.
Yeah. So,
you
know,
if a nigga in the middle of the street, I'ma go nigga. You
they
right?
Have pretty good roses.
They do.
It would be good. It's still cute. It doesn't
sparkle. So you got a couple of them roses?
I have them inside of the road roses.
What's wrong with them though? Y'all
there's
feel like
nothing
wrong with them.
Nothing's wrong.
It's
just
the,
make
it's
sure
the,
it's
the
not
thought.
Willing.
It's the thought that count. And they still roses.
Right. They gonna die anyway.
Now, I didn't went to the flower shop and damn it got the same amount of roses for a higher price.
$1,000. Bruh, next time you gotta go to downtown LA through the fucking what do they call it?
The
Flores District.
Yeah.
And you go
like,
buy like a dozen for $3.
Really?
Right. Okay.
Yeah, really.
You
I think the last time I bought some roses, it was down there.
You get her whole name for $100.
You already on it.
Oh.
Have you ever bought a
ideas.
From the,
Games.
From the club ladies that go around?
No, no. I'm in the club. I hate leaving the club and they right there trying to sell shit. I'm getting up out of here, right? Straight up.
Now, would you rub her toes? Now, this is your lady, not just any woman, right? Would you rub her toes, give her a massage, being romantic, all that stuff?
Yeah, like, it ain't nothing wrong with that.
Okay.
I'm not gonna sit up here and just tell everybody I be doing it, but like, ain't nothing wrong with that. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's y'all quality time. You feel me?
Okay, look at him. Okay, so you guys are listening to Champagne Party. We are here with Slim 400, brought to you by Marcus King Presents. And we was talking just a little bit about some rubbing the toes and some roses, but we gonna get into some other stuff after we come back to this break. Building brought to you by Marcus King Presents on Dash Comedy. We also got Mud in the building. Yeah, Mud, you didn't let us know about that booty video.
Hold on.
We was waiting on you. It was all you. All you.
You was in the video?
No.
No, he was supposed to let us know about
so we can.
You didn't let us fucking know?
No, he didn't let us know.
Who didn't see booty shaking and ass shaking? Get your ass on the mic. Get on the fucking mic right now and tell us why you did not invite us.
Right, we was trying
to
do
that. But they're not cute enough? They're not meet the cut?
Slim put out a casting call on his Instagram.
Okay.
Oh, so you couldn't personally. Like, no,
okay. The whole
story just got short. Y'all both got last
words
today.
So y'all weren't paying attention.
It's our fault.
It's okay. But we're going to move past the videos. We're going to move past all the good times. Because something recently happened. And, you know, we want to talk about it and get to exactly what happened, how you're feeling, how you're doing, and everything about how you recently got shot.
I'm going to start off by saying, like I said, God is good. I'm blessed.
All the time.
Just on some random shit, man. Just, you know, I'm putting up in my neighborhood, seeing my folks, trying to say what's up before I hit the road, do some shows, and some shit transpired, and you know, it could have caused my life, but, you know, I'm blessed and I'm here. Right. Other than that, I don't really want to speak too much on it, but, like, I'm just blessed, man. Right. Whatever the YouTube said, the blogger said, you feel me, it's kind of halfway right. I did take 9.
That's what I was going to ask. Damn.
It just, it was a tragic moment. You
where on you did you take the 9?
Shit. Upper shoulder, stomach, face, ear, shit like that.
Face?
Yeah, man, my jaw.
And you bounce back like ain't shit happened. Like, right. I'm just like, man,
you have a purpose. You're blessed for sure.
Yeah, that part.
Maybe, I personally think, I mean, I know you don't want to talk about it, but it's the only thing I'm going to say, that maybe your angels or somebody was protecting you, you know? Like, some spirits on the other side.
When I talk to my bros, they basically say, man, look, God got you. And your boy Nip was just on some shit like, they can't take you. He with you. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm hearing from YG. When I talk to YG, like, man, Nipsey had you, man. Like, hey, blood, Nipsey had you. And I'm like, for sure, because the way he went out, it was kind of crazy. But me taking 9, it's like, damn, I had to really ask the doctor, like, man, how many times I got shot?
Right.
She told me I couldn't believe it. So that is motivating me just to start walking. You know what I'm saying? Like, start all the shit that they trying to say I can't do or it's going to take a little more time to do.
Right.
And that's walking around the hospital, getting up by myself, using the restroom by myself, all that type of shit, just to show them, you see what I'm saying? Blood pressure, sugar, like all that shit had to meet a certain, like, number on the little machine. So I'm going through that shit for like 15 days, and shit, they let a nigga out, man.
Wow.
I was so happy. Well, I jumped up and threw the flowers away that was dead. Right. You know, I'm packing my shit, getting the cards, like, I'm out of here.
God was like, it's not his time.
For the most part, like I said, I'm good, man. Shit ain't gonna stop me within the Lord. Yeah. Shit, you see, I'm right here, man.
Right. And as soon as you left the hospital, so you've been in the studio, you've been doing events, you've been out here doing some work.
I just feel like I said, YG basically was saying, like, you know, like, I think a dip had you, you know what I'm saying? Like, God got you, like, so.
Dude, when
you know, it's the marathon continues, so I can't just get out this slowpoke, like, they got shit to do, money to make, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. So when something like this happens, is there, like, a point in time where you actually, did you actually pass out, or?
Yeah, I passed out, and one of my relatives, like, kind of, you know, kind of kept me, like, talking, and dragged me in the house, you know what I'm saying?
Did you hear them the whole time?
Huh?
Could you hear them the whole time while they were talking to you, or you just?
I heard them, but I didn't hear them. You see what I'm saying? But from them, from my cousin grabbing my body and shit and pulling me and trying to get me up, I felt that I'm hearing shit but not hearing it. But I'm just going what she telling me to do. You see what I'm saying? And that's how I was able to get in the hospital until the ambulance came. And from there, shit, I really woke up in the hospital, like, not knowing where I'm at and seeing people I know but not knowing it's them at the moment type shit.
Yeah.
What was your reaction? Like, were you scared when you were seeing people, not really knowing who they were or what happened?
I'm actually scared because at this moment I'm in the hospital, so it's like for me to be have to talk to the doctor, like, do you know where you at? What's your name? And how many fingers I'm holding up and shit like that. Mm-hmm. Whoever I'm seeing behind that, I know they good people. So you know what I'm saying? So I'm tripping and scared on that level, but for the most part, I was halfway here. You feel me?
Yeah. Right. Do you have any kids?
Yeah, I got a daughter. Her name is Paris.
Aww. Yeah, you might want to start having some more because you're really lucky. Like,
I've been thinking about it, but I just feel like I got to just take my career to another level real quick.
Yeah,
so once I get to another level and really stable to where it's officially like set in stone, then I'll probably start giving up my con.
Okay. Giving up my con.
What a way to put it.
Y'all can't have it just yet.
Hold on. I'll use the rubbers.
I think Sophia trying to give you a baby. Oh. I think Sophia trying to give you a baby.
And whoever has kids
trying to give you a miracle baby.
She's nasty.
Last time. Nuh-uh. That nasty one's over there. I never carried around a little 6-inch dildo in my purse.
Me?
What? Oh my. Yes, you did, bitch. Either. Yes,
what?
I did.
Oh, love.
It was not carried around.
Was it purple or was it brown?
Bitch, yes,
I carried it to the studio in my purse.
Okay. Why?
How did you lose it?
That's what we were doing.
Hold on.
Someone stole your dildo?
Yes.
No.
No. What happened was we were, you know, on the show, we were bringing out, you know, toys and, you know, the freaky stuff. So she brought her shit with the anal ease and
all
that.
Yeah, she had anal ease too. I never carried anal ease either.
Why is he looking at me like this?
I'm trying to wonder, like, you don't be getting that like that, or like?
I mean, you know, at the time I had a boyfriend, okay. And well, the anal ease. I just wanted to try something new. Now the dildo thing. When he's a gone, like,
when he's a gone.
He travels
a lot.
Okay.
Well, he did.
I'd rather you have a deal though when I'm gone to travel versus like really out here cheating on a nigga. Like, that's
He was in the entertainment business, so yeah, he traveled a lot.
He was a basketball player, right?
No.
He played for the Lakers.
Don't get her in trouble.
He played for the Lakers, right?
Okay.
New team or the old team?
No, none of that.
Sophia got the new team.
Has anything changed, like your mindset of what you were trying to do before, you know, everything happened with you getting shot versus now? Like, is anything different than before? Like, your plans that you were trying to do?
I mean, plan-wise, they still, like, I'm still lining it up. Certain things is happening. I didn't kind of fulfill certain goals, but for the most part, the way I think, my mindset is just like, you know, don't take shit for granted. You know, move like something can happen. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. So more security.
Right.
Certain places I normally just pop out and go by myself, whatever the case may be. I'm just gonna always have a bro or two with me just on some extra eyes.
Right.
And shit, gone by my day, man. I can't keep dwelling and worrying about,
right.
All right, these niggas are still out here, but damn, right. Like, what's gonna happen if I'm ever running to them? I don't wake up and like think like that. I don't give a fuck about running to a nigga. Nah, it's just this go around, they better be ready type shit. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
Other than that, I'm focused on my career, this ice water shit, and you know, doing this acting shit, kind of come with these movies. I ain't playing.
Okay,
it's
acting,
like,
right? Okay. Like,
and staying sober. The doctor told me I can't drink or smoke, you know what I mean, for like 2 months. So,
okay, I was
like, wait a minute,
what?
Wait, 2 months?
That ain't too long for me, but that's giving me a time span to where, like, I'm open. You see what I'm saying? Because
right.
I think it was faded within the music I was doing in the past. I was under some type of influence every day with the drink, marijuana, something. You see what
right.
I'm saying? Vaping, something. So now I can't do nothing. It's like my mind is just open.
Clarity.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I'm seeing shit that I probably didn't see. You feel me?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you have different dreams now because you're more sober? Because I know that it does raise your vibrations because we're very spiritual. So you could definitely have like more premonition dreams and like accomplishing.
Here she go.
No, I'm serious.
You
can,
all this happened.
You can manifest.
I had no dreams though.
Oh, okay.
I had no dreams.
You can manifest though more when you're sober. So definitely, you know, do the manifestation things that you want. You know.
I feel you. It's just shit. When I go to sleep, I'm watching Marlon Wayans and Jamie Foxx. Doze off or something. Real shit.
Dream about shit. So how is your family? Is your family like really supportive, worried about you? Are they really behind you?
They were supportive before, so now they just actually text a nigga, you see what I'm saying, calling me randomly.
Right.
And it's like, God damn, I ain't doing nothing. You see what
right.
I'm saying? I'm in the house or I'm with my manager. Other than that, I appreciate them and love them death. You see what I'm saying? Because, like I said, it was a moment to where I didn't know if I was gonna make it or not, so
right.
for them to be hitting me daily, you know what I mean, and very often, like, what's going on, y'all? Where you at? What you doing today? Who you gonna be with? And,
right.
It's just a blessing, just because, like, all that shit could be just took instantly. You
right.
know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And it definitely affect a lot of people around, even people you didn't know, fans of yours, even us. Because I know when we first heard about it, I was like, hell no. I was like, what the hell? Just I was like, shut up. And then just all the information coming in. You actually inspired me and Tamara to come up with a movie. So, you know, we was like, hell no, fuck that shit. We about to, we gonna talk about that later. We ain't gonna talk about it on there, but... Yeah, so it's definitely a real situation. And what about, have you ever thought about like talking to kids, going to schools, and kind of having them aware of situations like that?
I was just talking to Mud Dollars, like, we got to just start doing something different to where now that they looking at me like, okay, like, or he got shot, so damn, like we already know he was a thug or he was in the streets, et cetera. So I gotta switch my whole MO. So for me to switch it, I'm coming with the talking to kids or just speaking my mind on a positive level. You know what I'm saying? And putting myself into like situations that involve like giving back or community type shit. Yeah.
Now, do you feel that you have to give back to the community?
No, I don't feel it, but it's just within love, and I'm out the kindness of my heart. Like, I always been that type of dude, like helping people out and, you know, giving them certain type of advice on certain things. So at this moment, why not go the extra mile and do it to where the public eye realizes it? You see what I'm saying? Right. It's like, okay, Slim ain't that type of person, or we thought he was, but he's kind of different now. Like, I guess them bullets slowed him down, and they did, so you feel me?
But it also needs to be that the community needs to appreciate you as well. Because, you know, sometimes, you know, you can do so much for the community, so much for a certain person.
They still overlooking you and don't care about nothing.
Right. So sometimes that's why it's like, sometimes you got to do you, whatever you feel that you need to do, but don't feel that you have to do.
I don't look like that. The only thing I feel like I have to do is take care of my daughter. You know what I'm saying? I don't care for no girlfriend, no baby mama, no, none of that. I just care about my daughter. So within my heart and my mind, I have to take care of her. Other than that, of course, I do everything else because I want to, and I just got an open heart. You know what I'm saying?
Cool. And you guys are listening to Champagne Party, and we are here with Slim 400, brought to you by Marcus King Present. And we're about to cut to a little break, and we're going to come back.
Hola.
And what's up, y'all? This is Tamara, and we are here with Slim 400.
Did you just say Hunter?
Slim 400. Professional ass fucking.
Wait a minute, y'all didn't even let me finish. Can I finish?
Joe, tree hopping ass.
That's exactly what I was thinking. I
mean, parachute driving ass.
That's awesome.
Grocery bags.
And y'all are here on Marcus King Presents - Comedy F, y'all, okay?
Y'all.
Slim 400, okay? I can say it how I want to say it. It's spoke Hunter.
Hunted.
Is it spelled hunted?
It's tatted right there. You don't see?
Yeah. How do you spell hunted?
Look, it's right there. It's right there.
100.
I'm sorry for butchering your name.
She wants the whole $100 bill.
Hey, we know what you mean.
Hunted.
I'm giving you a hard time.
I'm so sorry.
Mm-hmm. All right, Slim. So tell us what you got coming up. Like, what is your next project? What are you trying to do? Events?
I got I'm actually working on tape right now. And like I've been saying all dang, I already put the title out there because, Los Angeles, California.
You said that last time. You didn't want to put the title.
That's how it remained what I wanted it to be. You see what I'm saying? Because you talk too much, niggas don't steal your shit.
That is true.
So, in my mind, I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm coming with, but I'm just working on new songs, getting different features that y'all ain't thinking I'm going to get. And, just plotting on these visuals, you know what I'm saying? And in the meantime, I'm going back to my old shit, knocking out a couple of them with other artists that I already done did shit with that got a little spare time that can pull up, or if I can fly out to them, I'm flying out, depending on who they are, and if I really need it, I'm pulling up, you know what I mean?
Is there anyone that you looking to work with, having them feature on your music?
Real, on this new tape, I'm trying to work out this little 50 thing, you see what I'm saying? He just hit a nigga on the gram, blessing me. So I'm about to run my game.
Oh, that's gonna be nice.
You know what I'm saying? See where it get me.
Right.
Just
don't
borrow no money from him.
Okay. You know, I hit you on a Monday. Like, where the fuck my money at?
I'll
say this, though. This is what I think. Niggas put they self in situations like that because they just, I don't know what they thinking and I don't know why they do it, but me, I'll say this. I don't borrow money from just regular niggas, right. And I don't really borrow money. You know what I'm saying? I'm broke, or I'm about to go get it some type of way, or I'm about to come up with a little plan or something. Because I hate to be getting calls like, what's going on, bro? You got that?
Right.
Like, bro,
he's
what's
he's
up,
a
boy?
Mess on it.
That's
he's
out.
He's out on social media. He ain't
for a nigga that really put you out there and make you look like a fool, that's my dislike. Right. So I'm saying with a person like that. So by me already knowing that's my dislikes, I don't put myself in that position. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
I think some of that he's just playing.
He is playing because like, come on, man. Like, that's so much money, he ain't really worrying about it.
Right.
If he was, he wouldn't even gave it to you.
Right.
But for you to need it, he gonna make the joke.
Right.
So my thing is, don't joke with me.
Right,
so
right.
For you not to be joked on, it's like, don't even get the money from
him. Yeah.
Right, situation.
And everybody wants to know, is there a tour coming? Because everybody wants to see you.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, me and Mud and Empire, we trying to put together some shit right now. And we just reaching out to different promoters that we already been messed with in the past. That was cool. You know, everything we asked for and our writers. Like, because you might get a nigga that tell you this, tell you that, and soon you get to that city.
And
oh man, I'm gonna bring you the bottle,
right.
Or I'm gonna bring you the chips. And,
gotta slap a nigga in the face.
Like, nigga, if I ask for some Skittles, nigga, I need them.
Right.
Or I hit the stage. Now I'm wrong for not hitting the stage for some Skittles. It's like, nigga, look, you agreed to this. So we trying to go back to the people that treated us right. You see what I'm saying? Versus new people that we don't know when we be playing games. Because like I said, I ain't the one for the games. I ain't the one that's looking to disrespect you, but I can take it there because this is what you agreed to.
It's business.
You know what I mean? Straight up.
This is not
principles.
Type, like, for real. Okay. Well, let everybody know where they can find you on social media.
Oh, it's the same. Slim400BLK, and that's SLIM400BLK. Twitter, official Slim400. Google, YouTube, shit. Slim, SLIM, space bar 400. It's like, it's the same regular shit with me, man.
Okay, Slim is hot right now. As soon as you turn on internet, everything on him is popping up all over the place. I'm like, damn.
And I ain't gonna lie, half of it, not say it's lies, but it just, niggas make up their own story just to be in a mix of the shit.
Right.
Yeah, you know I mean, I done heard so much shit about a nigga, I just look at the shit and I laugh. You
like,
know
what
I'm saying? That's
crazy. What
they out there talking shit about?
For one, when the situation happened, like my manager tell me, he said, man, I heard you lost a leg.
Bro, when we got the info, my nigga, I swear, we was like, when he hit me and told me, we was on the fucking edge of the bed, like, bro, this nigga is about to lose his last breath right now. And then he was like, no, he good. Like, what the fuck kind of shit is this?
Yeah. I feel people that do that, they want their subscribers to go up.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? They want their YouTube channel to be popping, or that's the one that everybody supposed to go look at. It's like, all that shit is lies, and that affect a lot of people in this world that really care about you, because they have to look at this and listen to this live versus catching you walking and back on your regular 1-2. And it's like, wait, did he get shot or did he do this? It's like, it's a lot of them. You know what I'm saying? When they listen to you, it's like, bro, like, if y'all just chill out, don't worry about your subscribers, and let me come back and do my thing, it's gonna be believable to the public, but the public already looked at all the different YouTubes and don't know what the fuck to think. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's why you just gotta flag the video.
Oh God,
just flag it. You know,
false info.
Well, that's why we got him here. You know, so the real story can come out.
Exactly. Do you have any closing statements you wanna, you know, tell everybody out there that's listening?
I feel basically just go pick up the high trees. That's shit. All the major platforms and iTunes for sure. I got my weed shit popping. That's Cabby Cones, / Ice Water. We did a little collaboration. I'm about to have some flyer with another person, so I'm just on my business, you feel me? And like I said, Brandon Ice Water. I got different clothes, dad hats, shorts, hoodies, like this different shit I'm trying to do new to where it ain't just the same slim. You feel me?
Did you bring us a shirt?
Actually, we don't have none. Well, I got some. I left them at the house. We don't have I don't like. I probably had one small, an extra large, and it's like that was gonna be dumb just to bring that. Then everybody gonna be like, "Where mine at?" So you feel me? I ain't that type of nigga. If I can't give it all, I ain't gonna do nothing.
I'm just playing.
I take that XL.
Yeah, that part.
Well, we definitely appreciate you coming out to Champagne Party and you know talking to us, bullshitting with us, and letting us know the real.
Up top.
And you know, this is Champagne Party, ladies.
Thank you so much, Sophia Elizabeth.
And this is Tamara, aka the fierce one.
And this is Sparkle, Madam Sparkle. And we are out. This is Slim 400 in the building.
Oh, love.
Make sure you stay tuned next week.
Yeah.
Hey!
I'm about to smoke his dog. Tell a little story about some people that I know. They call me Blood Folks, put some G on my name.
Slim.
Converse shoes, I
stay. No more clean versions. This is not an elementary.
So I stay in my session. I did the dirty shit.
I was like,
we were just surprised when we walked in and we heard the edit.
We
was a part of y'all had.
They
sent
me clean versions.
That's what I
heard.
I need the dirty
version.
That's gross.
Ass,
pussy,
titties, and all that. Oh, shit. Yo, boy, look me up with some dirty shit.
Hit the gas, make the whole car
spin
around. Yeah, look, what up?
What up?
I'm trying to
pour
that.
The little part I gave you. Just a little
quick video. Come on, dude.
Hey, my DJ's gonna love this. Shout out to the LA Leakers.